So shall the Jews at Jerusalem bind the man that owneth this girdle, and shall deliver him into the hands of the Gentiles.
Agabus, New Testament prophet, he saw the girdle, let's say it's a belt, and pick it up. And said the owner of this girdle, when he gets to Jerusalem, this is the kind of suffering he's going to go through. Amen. If you know that story, immediately, all those that knew that that girdle was that of Paul, started telling Paul that, see now, the Holy Ghost said, don't go to... I want you to notice that the prophet did not say, don't go to Jerusalem. It is the conjunctions of people is that, we did say now, don't go. Now, I want to apply one scripture now. Believe a prophet, you will do what? You will prosper. All right, question. Did Paul go to Jerusalem? Did Paul go to Jerusalem? Yes. Did Paul go to Jerusalem? Yes. Did he believe the prophet? Yes. Eh? Did he obey the prophet? No. Did he obey the prophet? No. Did he obey the prophet? No. Eh? Did he obey the prophet? Why did Paul go to Jerusalem? Now you will see the difference between Old Testament and New Testament. Now, why did Paul go to Jerusalem? Despite the fact he was told that this girdle, this is what is going to happen to the owner of this girdle. Why? You need to go to Acts chapter 9. When God gave Paul the mandate for his ministry, God already told him that he will finish at Jerusalem. And he will suffer. God had already told Paul before. What God was only saying through the prophet is that you are now in that stage. Now, if any so-called prophet tells you something that does not line up with what God has told you before, it's either you are not in good relationship with God or you are stupid. New Testament prophets are supposed to confirm what God has told you before. So for those of you who wake up and know any small thing, let's call prophet. Prophet, king, prophet, what do you... You know, the day you will be shocked is the day that you call prophet and they say prophet don't die. Prophet himself don't die. What can you go do now? The moment the veil in the temple turned into two, that Old Testament type of prophetic office ended.